गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन। माय पेपर प्रेजेंटेशन इज कंबाइंड मैमोग्राफिक एंड सोनोग्राफिक इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ पैल्पेबल ब्रेस्ट मासेस एंड माय कोऑथर्स आर डॉक्टर प्रदीप कुमार एमडीआरडी प्रोफेसर एंड डॉक्टर पनील कुमार एमडीआरडी प्रोफेसर। कमिंग टू इंट्रोडक्शन, ब्रेस्ट कैंसर इज द लीडिंग कॉज ऑफ नॉन प्रिवेंटेबल कैंसर डेथ अमंग द वुमेन एंड अ पैल्पेबल मास इन द वुमेन ब्रेस्ट रिप्रेजेंट्स अ पोटेंशियली सीरियस लेजन and requires evaluation by history taking, physical examination and mammography. Mammography is a well-defined and widely accepted technique to evaluate the clinically suspected breast lesions and screening for breast cancer. In these patients, sonography is a useful adjuvant modality and helps in characterizing a mammographically detected palpable abnormality, especially in patients with dense breast. And the sensitivity and specificity of sonography and mammography is higher if sonography and mammography are combined. The aims and objectives are to evaluate the role of combined mammographic and sonographic imaging in patients with palpable abnormalities of the breast and to provide the systematic and practical approach to imaging evaluation of palpable breast masses and then evaluate its image characteristics, which helps in decision making by clinician as to go for biopsy or lesion follow-up. The source of data is collected from Department of Radiology, Shantiram Medical College, Nandal. Over a period of 18 months, 50 patients aged 30 or above with palpable abnormalities of breast underwent combined mammographic and sonographic evaluation. The inclusion criteria includes women with more than or equal to 30 years referred to the center with palpable abnormalities of breast. And the exclusion criteria is women less than 30 years of age with palpable abnormalities of breast and the women with fungating mass per breast and the mass adherent to chest wall where performing mammography was difficult. Mammography is performed with GE Sonograph 800 equipment and the sonography is performed with 7-10 MHz transducer of Siemens Rieter. Coming to the results and analysis, there were 50 patients with palpable abnormalities of breast who underwent combined mammographic and sonographic evaluation. The palpable abnormalities were reported in 29 patients in right breast and 19 patients in left breast and 2 patients on both sides. This is a table 1 showing the age distribution of patients in the study group. 25% of the patients with palpable abnormalities were in the age group of 30 to 39 and 15 were 40 to 49 and 6 were 50 to 59 and 4 patients more than 60. The 33 palpable abnormalities or the palpable lumps and 6 show palpable thickening and 6 nodularity and 5 are non-specified. And table 3 is the mammographic tissue density in the patient's study. 25% of the patients with palpable abnormalities show scattered fibroganglia density. 50 patients predominantly fatty parenchymal density. And the 3 palpable abnormalities were heterogeneously dense and the 2 were dense. This is the final assessment of a combined mammographic and sonographic evaluation of palpable abnormalities. The imaging findings were negative in 23 palpable abnormalities and benign in 20 palpable abnormalities and suspicious in 7 palpable abnormalities. Out of the 20 palpable abnormalities, 2 were cyst, 4 were fibroadenoma, 2 were verdactasia, and 1 fat necrosis and 1 fibrocystic disease. Table 6 is showing the sensitivity, specificity, positive and negative predictive value. The sensitivity is 100%, specificity is 84.3% and positive predictive value is 28.5 and negative is 100%. Out of the 20 palpable abnormalities were benign assessment and 12 benign lesions were visible on both mammography and sonography. 7 of the 20 benign lesions were mammographically occult and identified at sonographic evaluation. 1 lesion was sonographically occult and visualized on mammography. In 7 of the 50 cases, the imaging evaluation resulted in suspicious assessment and all of these underwent biopsy and 2 were diagnosed having malignancy. 23 of the 50 palpable abnormalities have negative imaging assessment findings. Of these 9 patients underwent biopsy and have benign findings, the sensitivity and negative predictive value for combined mammographic and sonographic assessment is 100% and the specificity was 80.1%. This is a case showing a calcified nodule consistent with fibroadenoma on mammography and this is an oval solid lesion with the posterior acoustic enhancement, which is this is a case of fibroadenoma. This is a well-defined homogeneous mass lesion on mammogram, which is confirmed with sonography as benign cyst. Here we can see the speculated dense mass lesion in the retroareolar region, which is a malignant mass. Here we can see multiple well-defined mass lesions on mammography. An ultrasound of the same patient showing multiple cystic lesions, which is a consistent with fibrocystic disease. Here we can see the speculated mass lesion characterized as high probability of malignancy confirmed with biopsy as malignant mass. Here we can see the giant fibroadenoma. Discussion. Breast carcinoma has been reported in 4% of the patients with breast symptoms and even among the palpable lesions undergoing biopsy. A large number of lesions turned out to be benign. The role of mammography in patients with palpable breast lumps is of benign cause for palpable abnormality and to avoid the further intervention. To support the earlier intervention for a mass with malignant features, screen the remainder of the ipsilateral and contralateral breast for additional lesions and to assess the extent of malignancy when cancer is diagnosed. In this study, 20 of the 50 lesions were characterized as benign after a combined mammographic and sonographic evaluation, clearly showing the value of imaging in helping avoid unnecessary biopsies. Sonography is complementary to mammography in patients with palpable abnormality. Its superiority over mammography in being able to show lesions obscured by dense breast tissue and in characterizing the palpable lesions that were sonographically visible or apparent. Mammography is complementary to sonography because of its ability to screen the remainder of the ipsilateral and contralateral breast for clinically occult lesions. It has been reported that accuracy of sonography is comparable with that of mammography as a screening modality for breast cancer. However, the role of sonographic screening for additional lesions in symptomatic patients has not been recorded. Conclusion: the combined use of mammography and sonography plays an important role in management of palpable breast lesions. The applications are: characterize the palpable mass lesion, avoid unnecessary interventions in which imaging findings were unequivocally benign. The negative findings on combined mammographic and sonographic imaging have very high specificity and they are reassuring to the patient. And these are my following references. Thank you.